everybody. Here we are, all ready to take you down to Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. Let's stop for a minute and take stock of ourselves. How do you feel this evening? Full of energy or tired and drowsy? If you're feeling all in, don't blame it all on your work. Think back. How well did you sleep last night? Not so good? Well, that might be your trouble right there. You're not getting the sleep you need. I suggest you'd better follow this plan. Drink a glass full of Horlicks tonight, just before going to bed. Don't eat a thing. The Horlicks will satisfy you. In addition, it will relax and refresh you, help you to get to sleep easily and naturally. You'll sleep more soundly, too. Horlicks digests quickly and thoroughly, and doesn't interfere with your rest as heavy food often does. Give this plan a trial, and see if you don't feel better tomorrow. You can get a package of Horlicks, you know, from your druggist in either natural or chocolate flavor. Now, let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. For the past few days, Lum and Abner have been very much concerned over the accidents Firestimp had while attending their picture show, the Pine Ridge Planetarium. However, they learned yesterday that Squire recovered sufficiently to make a business trip into the county seat. So evidently, his injuries are not as serious as was first thought. As we look in on our old friends today, we find a very heated game of checkers in progress at the Jot 'em Down store. Listen.
All right, let's see now. I believe I'll move right there. No, wait a minute now. I never take my finger off of it. I never die. Doggy, I like to run myself in. I'd give you 3 men if I'd move. Yes, sir, you'd sure got a king out of there. Well, let me see here now. If I move right there, then you'd have to... No, you don't. I've just seen that in time, too. Yes, sir. Yeah. You just might not have got me blocked here. Let's see. Ought to be somewhere here. Why, yeah, sure. What's the matter with me? Had a jump all the time and never even seen it.
What do you think you're doing?
Huh?
What are you doing sitting here talking to yourself about? I'll sit there and watch you for 3 minutes.
I just playing you a game of checkers, Mom. You weren't here, so I was playing for both of us.
Now, just put that checkerboard up. I told you I didn't want you playing checkers by yourself out of the way. Somebody come in here and hear you talking to yourself out of the way, they'll think you've lost your reason.
Well, there ain't nobody here to play with.
Well, why don't you straighten up the store? Look at that counter over there. All that ginghams and percal still scattered out there where you're showing Sister Simpson them dress patterns right early this morning. Why don't you roll them bolts up and put them back in the shelves?
Yeah, and then have to drag them all down again.
Drag them down again?
Yeah, she's taken a bunch of samples and said she'd make up her mind which piece she wanted and then come back the first of next week. I just made up my mind I'd learn her lesson. Just leave the whole work laying right where it's at.
You're going to learn her lesson by leaving all the bolt goods we got in the store there on the counter for a week, huh?
Yes, sir. Just learn her not to make a fella pull down every bolt of goods in the house. I'm just like Levi Whitten. When folks does something that you don't like, I learn them a lesson.
Levi Whitten. I don't know which one's yours, him or you. They're both of you.
Now, Levi's got a whole lot more sense than lots of folks give him credit for having.
Well, maybe he ain't much alike.
I know one thing. He sure got even with that bus line that runs through here for running over one of his homes. Taking him 6 months to study out a way to do it, but he sure got even with him.
Yeah, I thought Levi was over in Oklahoma visiting.
He is. That's the way he's getting even with him. When he left here, he bought a round-trip ticket on that bus line, and he ain't coming back on the bus.
He ain't coming back on the bus?
No, sir. He's going to walk every step of the way back just for spite.
Yeah, Levi's always getting even with somebody to hear his tell of it.
Well, he does, too. I don't know how he studied up them things.
Well, now, don't you start patterning yourself after Levi. One of him in a town this size is enough. Too many, in fact, is.
Just wish I knowed as much about government and how it ought to be run if he does. There's a fella that's made a study of government problems.
Well, you better find out how the store ought to be run, what you better be learning. Come on, let's get this stuff put back in the shed.
Hey, well, wait a minute. Here comes Cedric now, Lum. We can just get him to do it.
Oh, yeah. Where's he been?
Oh, he's taking a little batch of groceries over to Edgar's East Country.
Are there any more orders to deliver now?
No, that's everything, I reckon.
Well, I seen Mr. Squire out walking just now.
Well, whereabouts was he at, Cedric?
He was down there by Moe's Moochie Barbershop just a while ago.
Well?
Yeah, I seen him a few minutes ago myself.
Well, I never knowed he was up and around.
Yeah, he went to the county seat yesterday, you know that.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Cedric, straighten up all that bolt goods that's laying on the counter there and put it back up on the shelf nice.
Yeah.
Oh, shucks. I was hoping there weren't nothing for me to do so as I could lay down back there in the feed room and sleep for a little while.
Sleep?
Why don't you do your sleeping at night?
Well, I generally always do, but last night I didn't. It's got to where every night when I go home from the picture show, I've got to pound on the door there for an hour before my folks gets up to let me in, so... Last night, I just made up my mind I was just going to knock just one time. And they didn't come to the door to let me in, so I just stood there on the porch all night long.
Well, what in the world did you do that for, Cedric?
Well, I was getting tired of them making me wait every night, so I decided just to let them wait once and see how they liked it.
Well, I don't blame you neither, Cedric. Man tired out from a day's work, why, he's got to get some sleep.
Hey, you got even with your folks about like Levi Whitten there, Cedric.
Yes, Mama, I can show.
Well, now, get that bolt good straightened up right now, Cedric, and you'll have plenty of time to get some sleep before the show starts tonight.
Yeah, we don't want you going to sleep running them pictures.
No, Mama, I won't.
I just can't wait to see that picture we got for tonight.
Yeah, that ought to be a good one, all right. Ought to have a big crowd.
Oh, yeah. Well, the place has been packed every night since Squire's place has been closed.
Yeah. We sort of got things to ourselves now.
Did you talk to Squire a while ago when you seen him, Lum?
No, I started to, but he acted awful strange.
Strange?
Yeah. You know, Abner, I don't like to talk to you, but I wouldn't be surprised if that lick he got on his head never affected his memories.
Well?
I walked right up to him to speak to him, and he just turned and walked off like he never even saw me.
Well, I do know. Well, of course, now, Lum, it might be he just worried over that trouble he's got himself into.
What trouble?
Well, I don't know what it is, but, you know, he went into the county seat yesterday afternoon to see a lawyer, so it must be something serious.
That's right. I forgot about that.
Oh, yeah.
That's just about what the trouble is.
Yeah.
It's bound to be something terribly important for him to get up out of a sick bed to go see a lawyer about.
Yeah. I feel awful sorry for him. Special on him not plumb over that accident that he had in our picture show the other night.
Yeah.
Just looked like, more trouble the feller has, why, the more he gets.
Yeah, them as has gets.
Yeah.
That's old Eddard saying.
Yeah.
I wish there's some way we could help him.
Yeah.
If he's got to hire a lawyer, I might could save him that expense myself. Just handle a case for him myself. Not charging nothing for it.
Well, now, that'd be a nice thing to do, Lum. That'd show him how sorrowful we are about him, hurting himself in our picture show
about him. Yes, sir. I might have to call him up right now and see if there's any way we can help him in his court trial or whatever it is.
Yeah, why don't you do that, Mom? Sure.
Let's see. His ring is a long and too short thing.
Yeah, that's it. Long and too short.
This will show him that we want to be friends with him.
Uh-huh.
You know, I believe Squire's reformed himself now. Wait a minute. Hello? Squire? This is Lum Eddard talking.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why, Squire, me and Abner heard you was into the county seat yesterday to see a lawyer, so we figured you must be aiming on having some sort of a case in court, and I just want to tell you that I'd be glad to donate my service, give you all the legal advice I can, and not charge you a cent for it.
No, please.
Huh? Well, I didn't mean to be butting into your business, but I just picked it. Well, all right, sorry for you feel that way about it. Hello? Hello? Yeah.
What's the matter, Lum? What did he say?
Why, he acted like he sort of made him mad. Said for us to tend our own business. Said when he needed any legal advice from me, why, he'd call on me first.
Well, I do know. Reckon he will?
I don't know. I don't much think so. The way he slammed up the receiver there in my ear.
No. Well, I don't know, though, Lum.
Well, howdy, Dick.
Huh?
I never seen you coming in.
Oh, hello, Dick.
Come on in. Come in.
Yeah, I got a registered letter for you fellas, and I thought I'd better bring it over. It might be something important.
Got what kind of a letter, Dick?
A registered letter, Lum. You have to sign for it to show it you received it. I brought the book along. You can sign it down. Right there.
Oh, yeah, sure. I've saw them things before.
Well, I reckon who that could be from.
It's more likely from Evelina. I ain't heard from her since she went home.
Well, it's more likely who's from.
Well, no, it's postmark Nina. Addressed to you and Abner both.
Well, I reckon what she's writing both of us for.
Well, it must not be from her, Abner, if it's from Nina.
Oh.
It's wrote with a typewriter anyway, see there?
Well, open it up. Don't stand there and look at it all day.
Just looking at all them stamps on there. Hey, Lenny, that must have cost something to send that thing.
Yeah, it must be some valuable papers of some kind, Lum.
Valuable paper?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, good. Reckon who could be sending us some valuables right away? Says up here, return to box 276 in 5 days.
Well, let's see. Today's Thursday. We'll have to have that back in there by next Tuesday, won't we? I wish they hadn't sent it if we can't keep it.
Well, I do know. Clark, Clark, and Clark. Attorneys at law.
Oh, yeah, that's at the law firm in at the county seat.
Well, wanting some legal advice from me, Eric. Lum Edwards and Abner Peabody. Owners and operators of the Pine Ridge Planetarium. Pine Ridge. Gentlemen.
Well, that's nice of them to say that.
Acting on the instructions of our client, M.K. Skimp, of your city, we are entering suit in Chancery Court against your partnership in the sum of $1,000 for injuries and anguish our client has suffered as a result of an accident sustained in your theater, the Pine Ridge Planet.
Well, this more than explains Squire's urgent trip to the county seat yesterday. First, here's a special message to all mothers who are unable to nurse their babies. You will find that Horlick's malted milk is unsurpassed as a food for bottle-fed infants. Horlicks is made from only full cream milk, pasteurized to ensure purity, and modified with the nutritive extract of the choicest malted grains. This modification by Horlicks' special process acts upon the milk in such a way as to make it extremely digestible. Hence, Horlicks can be more easily, more safely handled by the tiny stomach than can ordinary cow's milk and many other infant foods. That is why Horlicks is so widely recommended by the medical profession as a food for infants. Try Horlicks for your child and start him off on the road to health. You can get a package of Horlicks from your druggist. This is Carlton Brickett, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlicks, who now bid you all good night and good health.